Sanskrit studies, we think others know better, and we have become the knowledge consumers. They are the knowledge producers. We are the consumers sitting at their feet. If the camera can zoom in on this, can you please zoom in on this? Isko zoom karenge, please. This book. If you look at the cover of this book, at the bottom, big image, is Sir William Jones and the Pundits. This is a huge carving on a wall in a chapel in Oxford. And it took me a long time to go in, get all the permissions and get the picture and all the high resolution. So this is, Sir William Jones said that he, and at the bottom it says, he gave the Hindus their laws. Okay, so he's shown writing some laws and dictating them, and these pundits are listening to him, and he's telling them their laws. He's telling them the Hindu laws. So now, in this book, I say that today, Sheldon Pollock would be giving the Hindus their human rights, because the whole idea of exposing human rights in Sanskrit, human rights problems, and telling them how to liberate and all that. So if one were to do a carving, if maybe the Murthy family one day sponsor such a carving, it'll be not only Indians, but they won't be sitting on the floor, they'll be sitting on sofas drinking whiskey, and they'll be the Indian elite, anglicized Indian elite. So Sheldon Pollock will be shown as teaching the Indian elite the human rights that they lack, and then there'll be another group of Indians writing checks and thanking him with a lot of money. So this is how the story of the British has shifted to control in the United States. This is a very important point that you made.